Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. There was a magnitude 3.95 earthquake near Bodfish at about 8:44 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. USGS said it was a magnitude 3.8. 72 people said they felt this earthquake, and they gave it an intensity level of 4, which means it was felt indoors by many, outdoors by a few. It would have woken some people up, and it did, according to reports on EMSC. Dishes, windows were rattling, automobiles, they would have noticed them rocking. This earthquake was reportedly felt as far as Los Angeles, and also West Covina. I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing that wrong. As far south as Porterville. Okay, and we got an intensity level of 4 here at Kernville. Two people reportedly said they felt it. Weldon, intensity level 4. Two people said they felt it. And then Lake Isabella, there was one report there, intensity level 4. There is one report from Lake Isabella on EMSC. In Porterville, they said there was a small, quick tremor, and that was, again, Porterville. From Corona, they said that was a short vibration when laying in bed and woke them up. From Tehachapi, they said it was a nice little shake, like someone shoved the bed back and forth. Let's see, like a big slap on the house. And it's a manufactured home, if that helps. And that came from Tehachapi also. A little shake, small shake, one quick jolt. Another one from Tehachapi says, we live in Golden Hills and felt like a quick jolt. Now from Kernville, 3 miles north of Kernville, felt like shaking, but much more than anything was a very loud rumble from our mountains. There is no damage. Well, thank God for that. Another report from Kernville. Okay, here's the one from Lake Isabella. Rumble and squeezing of the house. Distant sound, Lake Isabella. Now, this is close to the area of Ridgecrest, where they've been having a lot of earthquakes. We'll go to the location of today's earthquake, which is over here. This is the Kern River Canyon Fault System that it's near. And let's go to the earthquake that occurred 2 days ago, which was by Ridgecrest. Let's bring this out. The blue line, that is the Walker Lane seismic zone. Now, originally, USGS had the earthquake listed over here, close to some kind of facility, and then they revised it to this location. Okay, so let's bring this out. What they're really concerned about was after this 2019 7.1 earthquake is that it reactivated the fault zone for the Garlock fault, which runs all the way down to the San Andreas fault zone. And yeah, both these earthquakes were close to the Garlock fault zone. There was an earthquake prior to this 3.6, which was a magnitude 3.5, according to USGS. 16 people said they felt that one. That one was at 4:34 a.m., whereas the 3.8, let me go back here, was at 8:44 a.m. And let me bring this down to the moment tensor ball. They actually got it here now. Yeah, we got spreading. The fault line opened up and spread. Tension was applied, supposedly, going towards the east. The fault line dipped. You can see that there. And yeah, spread open. Over here on the left is the Kern Valley Fault Zone. And then over here is the foreshock, I guess you would call it a foreshock, of the 3.5. Something else I want to show you. Okay, here's the 3.6. Let's see, there's been a lot of earthquakes in that location. Right there. Oh, that was another one. Hold on. Yeah, a lot of earthquakes in this location of threes and higher. All right, there's the 3.6. That was today's. And let me bring this out because I want to show you something here. How the Kern Valley Fault System, it comes down, curves around, and goes into the White Wolf Fault Zone, which runs straight through here, which in 1952 they had a magnitude 7.7. Okay, and then it runs all the way into here to the San Andreas Fault Zone. Yeah, that 7.7, boy, that created a lot of damage. Tunnels up over here for the railroad. The walls of the tunnel were actually lifted up and set back down on top of the railroad lines. Yeah, this here is tunnel 3. I think that could have been the one that the whole wall of the tunnel going through for the railroad line. Yeah, it rose up, moved the tracks, or the tracks actually moved, oh, probably close to maybe 5 feet, set the mountain back down right on top of the railroad tracks. I'll give you a link to that destructive earthquake. Yeah, can you imagine a 7.7? There's the railroad tracks, and there's the wall that was set on top. Another image of Tunnel 3. Let me make that bigger for you. I can't. I'm sorry. There, I just made the page bigger. Get around making it larger for you. You can see how the railroad tracks, yeah. Yeah, so it gives you an example of how large of an earthquake this area can have. Here's an image of Tehachapi Main Street after that earthquake. And another image of the damage. This, too, is very close to Bakersfield. And we have noticed, I'm sure you have noticed, that the earthquakes have increased. And they're getting larger. Yeah, 7.7. So let's go back to today's earthquake. Yeah, look how close that is. Yeah, I certainly hope you guys are prepared for a large earthquake. You have a plan. Lots of times when cell phones go down, you can still do text messaging. So please share my videos. Please subscribe. If you felt this earthquake, please put those comments down below. Did you have any damage? Thank you again for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.